FHTM was a company that was started in order for people to be able to give and give more. Many of us at the corporate office give, not in a proud way, not do I sit here today and tell you that in some proud, puffed up way we give. But we are instructed by the Bible and in the Bible to give. Give and ye shall receive. And I'm not here to preach to you, that's the good news. Many of our fine representatives throughout the United States, Canada, Puerto Rico, and the United Kingdom are givers. They were givers before they got into this business, and with the money they've been able to make from the FHTM business, they're even bigger givers today. One such person is a man who's on the Ring of Honor, a person I'm very proud of from the state of Michigan, Aaron Decker. Aaron has been with FHTM for many years, and he did not start out as a great success story in Fortune high-tech marketing. It took him years and years and years to build a base, to keep learning about what he was trying to do. But through his Roanoke Ranch for Kids, he has become a big-time giver. And the good news about Aaron is, and was, Aaron was a giver again before he got to FHTM. And now that he's in FHTM, he's able to do more for more people. Money doesn't make you bad, folks. Good people with money can do more good than good people without money. It's that simple. If you're a giver and you have more money, you'll give more. If you're not a giver, you can have all the money in the world. It won't change one thing. Aaron Decker, I'm very proud to say, is a big-time giver. And I'd like to introduce you to Aaron Decker, Ring of Honor member, National Sales Manager from the state of Michigan, my friend.
When I first got introduced to FHTM, it was all about giving back to other people. My first training that I got to experience here with this company was, when you get your first check, give some of it back. And what I remembered as I started, because I was still riding horses, still rodeoing, and really that's how I was earning a living at that time, because I had just lost everything prior to being introduced to this company. But one of the things that I realized is at the bigger rodeos that we would go to, there'd be busloads of kids, and as these groups of kids would inevitably come through on tours or field trips, a lot of the different cowboys and cowgirls, get away from my horse, but you'd always see these kids in the back of the line, and we all know what they look like. Their shoulders are down, their heads are down, they're kind of just looking at, they're not the people that really fit, and so I always made it my mission to really kind of get their attention, and it was so special when you'd grab the little boy or little girl and you'd put them up on that horse, and for a moment they'd start to smile and they'd get these big smiles, but every single time there would be the people, the cool kids in the front of the class or the front of the line, they'd come around, they'd come running, and it was amazing because they'd say, I want to get on the horse. And without even having to ask or even saying, hey, you got to get on, the little boy or the little girl that was on the horse, they would automatically start to get off. And it was almost like it was just instilled in these people, you don't deserve, or these young kids, you don't deserve. And it was so fun to say, no, wait a minute. You just go ahead and stay on there and tell that other person, that little boy or little girl, get in the back of the line. And when that happened, it didn't matter if it was a young boy or a young girl, every single time, they put their shoulders back and they'd puff their chest out and they'd smile. And for a moment in time, they were special and they were worthwhile and they were worth something. And so as I started to gain a little bit of success here with FHTM, immediately, it was something that I was passionate about, and we started with some day camps, and that increased, and ultimately was introduced to somebody who encouraged me actually to start a nonprofit, and I've always been passionate about helping people. I mean, I would do anything for anybody, and in a typical year at the ranch, we'll have anywhere from 150 to 300 kids that will attend, and we do some day camps, but most of them are structured camps. We try now to do things year round. It's difficult. We operate on a very tight budget, but we do whatever we can. We don't charge anybody to come to the ranch. We welcome everybody and have been extremely blessed with a lot of volunteers. We're just a tool, I believe, that God uses, and we've been blessed with a lot of people that believe in us and that have allowed us to do what we do. It's definitely not me. I think the rock of the ranch really is my fiance, Kat. She's absolutely amazing. She's allowed me to go out and actually work and build my FHTM business, which helps primarily support the ranch as well as, network with a lot of other people. I'll tell you, one of the stories early on with one of the groups was a young man. I was actually showing my FHTM business to somebody, and we got to talking about, you know, passions, and I got to share the ranch story with him. And he told me about, he was a football coach, and he had a young boy who was 13 years old that got in some trouble. He actually was caught stealing a pair of tennis shoes with some of his cousins, and they called him Big O. Big O was about 300 pounds. He's 13 years old, and he's never been really out of the city. And we had to commit to, he had to do some community service, and so we had different volunteers that would pick him up. My dad picked him up, and I did, different people did. And he'd come out and he'd work at the ranch, and you know, the first day out there, I mean, this boy is, I don't think he's really ever worked a day in his life. And we had him stacking wood, cleaning stalls, raking leaves. You know, he had to do projects, and I mean, he was very, very upset, quite honestly. He did not want to be there, absolutely not. But what he started to see is he started to see other kids come down there, and they'd be putting on horses. And he started eyeing those horses, and one of the ladies that's a big asset to the ranch, he asked her when she was walking by, he said, you know, I want to get on one of those horses. She said, well, you got to get your work done first. And, you know, I don't know Big O has ever had anybody tell him, hey, you got to do something before you get something. Well, a very long story short, Big O came down there the rest of the summer, and he learned to ride a horse. And at the end of the year, he really wanted to, he wanted a job. He asked if he could continue to come back there. And so we made it so that summertime he could come and he'd do little projects around the ranch, and we'd give him a little bit of money here and there. And, you know, he'd saved up his money, and it's an amazing story. The holiday at the end, I think it's Labor Day weekend, and everybody else, his family actually was going out of town, and his mom called me up. She said, would it be okay? Big O wants to come out to the ranch. I said, well, there's really nothing going on for him to do. I mean, everybody's kind of out of town. It's vacation. She said, well, he said he'd rather come to the ranch than go hang out with his cousins and do that. I said, okay, well, send him out. She says, that I thought you should know, he's been saving his money all summer long because he wanted to buy a pair of tennis shoes. But his grandma got sick and she needed some money for some medication, and he gave her that money. It absolutely just tore me up. And I'll tell you, I made sure that I went there and picked him up that day, and, you know, just made up some kind of project, picking up rocks or whatever it was. You know, because he learned that lesson, you know, I mean, we went out and we bought him not one pair, but two pairs of shoes. And it was just the most amazing experience. And I just hope and pray that he takes that with him for the rest of his life. If I can be an encourager and I can instill that into these youth to not tear people down, but to build people up, to not discourage, but encourage people. And if we can teach our youth to encourage each other, and sometimes you'll get maybe in a group of kids, the kids that aren't the cool kids are the first ones on the horses. And the kids that typically come across as, you know, I'm cool, I'm too bad, they're usually the most scared. But here's what you always find. Those other kids, they put all that stuff aside, and they'll encourage those other kids to get on those horses. And it's magical. I think Winston Churchill said it best. There's something about the outside of the horse that's good for the inside of a man. And I think that's just an amazing quote. And it's not just the inside of a man, but it's the inside of a boy or a girl. I think for all of us, horses are absolutely magical.